Hello students, welcome back. Exercise 9C, Concepts Mathematics 8th class. Let's go to 12th problem. Calculate the difference between the compound interest and simple interest on rupees 7500. P is equal to rupees 7500 in 2 years. Time is equal to 2 years at 8% per annum. Rate is equal to 8%. Compound interest. A is equal to P into 1 plus R upon 100 raised to the power of 2. This is 1.08. 7500 into 1.08 square. So 1.08 into 1.08. You get 1.1664 into 7500. These two zeros, 1234, rupees 8748 is the amount. So compound interest is equal to 8748 rupees minus 7500. We get 1248. Rupees 1248 is the compound interest. Now let us calculate simple interest. Simple interest is equal to P R T upon 100. 75 into 16. So rupees 1200 is the simple interest. So the difference between compound interest and simple interest is equal to 1248 minus 1200. That is rupees 48. Rupees 48 is the difference between the compound interest and simple interest. 13th problem is a similar one. Calculate the difference between the compound interest and simple interest on rupees 8000. P is equal to rupees 8000 in 3 years. Time is equal to 3 years. At 10% per annum. Rate is equal to 10% per annum. A is equal to P into 1 plus R upon 100 raised to the power of 3. This is 1.1 cube. 8000 into 1.1 cube. When 1.1 is multiplied 3 times, we get 1.331 into 8000 into 8000 is equal to these three zeros, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So 10,648 rupees. 10,648 is the amount. So compound interest is equal to rupees 10,648 minus 8000, rupees 2,648. This is the compound interest. Now let us calculate the simple interest. Simple interest is equal to P R T upon 100. Rupees 2400 is the simple interest. 2648 minus 2400. So this 248. Rupees 248 is the difference between compound interest and simple interest. 14th problem. Rohit borrowed rupees 40,000. P is equal to rupees 40,000. For 2 years, time is equal to 2 years, rate is equal to 10% per annum, compound interest. Manish borrowed the same sum for the same time. This is Rohit and this is Manish. At 10.5% per annum, simple interest. 10.5%, this is compound interest and this is simple interest. Which of these two gives less interest and by how much? So A is equal to P into 1 plus R upon 100 raised to the power of 2. This is 1.1. 0.1 plus 1 is equal to 1.1. 1.1 square, 2 decimal places, 1.21. So this is 1.21. 40,000 into 1.21 is equal to 4 zeros, 12. 48,400. 48,000 minus 40,000 is equal to compound interest rupees 8400 is the compound interest. Let us find out the simple interest now. Simple interest is equal to P T R upon 100. This is 800 into 10.5. This is also rupees 8400. Compound interest and simple interest are same. 15th problem. Mr. Sharma lends rupees 24,000. P is equal to rupees 24,000 at 13% per annum simple interest, and an equal sum at 12% compound interest. Find the total interest earned by Mr. Sharma in 2 years. Time is equal to 2 years in both the cases. We have to calculate compound interest and simple interest, then add them. Here simple interest is equal to P R T upon 100. So 240 into 26. Rupees 6240. This is the simple interest. Let us calculate compound interest now. A is equal to P into 1 plus R upon 100 raised to the power of 2. This is 1.12. 24,000 into 1.12. If you multiply 1.12 twice, you get 1.2544 into 24,000. 1, 2, 3, 4. The amount is equal to 30,105.6 rupees. Therefore, the compound interest is equal to 30,105.6 minus 24,000. Is equal to 6,105.60 is the compound interest. The total interest earned by Mr. Sharma is equal to 6,240 plus 6,105.60. So ₹12,345.60. 16th problem. Peter borrows ₹12,000 for 2 years. P is equal to 12,000 rupees for 2 years at 10% per annum. Rate is equal to 10% per annum compound interest. He repays ₹8,000 at the end of first year. Let us find out what is the amount at the end of the first year. Simple interest is equal to P R T. That's for 1 year upon 100. ₹1,200. So amount is equal to 12,000 plus 1,200. That is equal to ₹13,200. This is the amount at the end of first year. This is the amount at the end of first year before making the payment. So he makes the payment of 8,000. So the amount at the end of first year after making the repayment is equal to ₹5,200. This becomes the principal for the second year. For second year, the principal is equal to ₹5,200. Therefore, interest is equal to P T R upon 100. 520 rupees. Therefore, amount is equal to principal plus interest. 5,200 plus 520, that is ₹5,720. This is the amount to be paid at the end of the second year to clear the account.